sometimes when we come back, even though it's only been a week or two, people are like, I'm glad you guys are back. That gives me a lot of reward because I don't know, who knows what is it that people are looking for in Tango Soul. I think it's a very interesting name to have Tango and Soul, but we work more and focus more on the Soul than the Tango.
If you start it here, as you move your legs, you gotta stay in the same place. I'm still there, I move my foot.
At Tango Soul, we approach Argentine tango from the perspective of the music, then the connection and the embrace, how two people embrace, how they hug. In Argentina, we say hug. We teach people how to hug because there are different cultures here. Mostly if you teach in Toronto, it's very multicultural. So it's a little bit closer. Then it comes the walk, and the steps are the last thing that we focus on. So we have 1 hour of our classes in which in that first hour, people that have first been dancing, you know, a couple of weeks or a couple of months, even a year or 3 years, they can come into the class and we just focus on their body, placement, walk, and embrace. It's a class in which we touch on different orchestras, how different sequences are done depending on the orchestra that you're dancing, and how you should adapt that embrace and that walk to fit the music.
It's really important for Bryant and I know that every time we walk into a classroom, what we try to do is not have a preset plan of what we want to teach, but look at what we have in front of us and just serve them so that we can help them at the level they're at, you know, meet them at their needs.
My philosophy of teaching is more about sharing and finding the needs of people. As a teacher, I find that all I have to do is not to mess up their learning process.
Both slightly bent. My cross step, watch my cross step now. And look at this, what's happening here? You see there's an extra bend there.
I would say with Faye and Bryant, what's so extraordinary about these two is that they're both artists, first and foremost, and that they're able to break down the language of dancing to a fundamental level where everyone can pick up something.
They're focused on the embrace. They make sure students fully understand, fully grasp the concept of the embrace, and that they learn how to recognize it when they dance.
They'll come over and they'll move your body and twist you around and get you going where you should be. There's always an adjustment, and it's always when Faye O'Brien says, "Eso," it's like, yay, we're getting something done.
For a long time, I didn't have an example of a woman in Argentine tango that danced the way I used to see the woman or the way I used to feel the women. Nowadays, I can say that Faye is probably one of the best examples for me to have my students look at, because they have a woman model. And so now I can tell them, listen, look at her, look what she does in the music.
Tango to me is a different pathway. What's a different pathway I took? It's nothing I had planned in my life. And I think that they often say that, you know, you don't choose tango, tango chooses you. And in my case, it was absolutely true. Well, I met my partner who became my husband, so my life took a different path. But ultimately, it's made me a better woman. I've been able to discover really who I am, and I think that if I look back, that's what I was looking for. that's where it's really beautiful with some ladies, where the tango becomes not just something you do as a dance, but it becomes part of who you are and part of your life.
The reason we don't have any levels at Tango Soul, it's because I didn't learn to dance with levels. And at the beginning, I really fought it, and a lot of people wanted to structure my school into a levels, kind of level school. But I found it a little bit of a cheating myself, teaching people how to dance in levels when I didn't learn how to dance in levels. The development in Tango Soul, and not by having levels, is just like an athlete learns its sport. If you have someone that does skiing, they have to go up and down the mountain thousands of times. If you have someone that it's a sprint runner, he has to run that track thousands of times. How you develop an expert sportsman or woman, it's by going deeper into their development, not by letting them pass to a next level without really them achieving it. I think in that sense, I grew up in an era where you weren't giving an easy time when you were learning. You had to really fight for it.
Like a lot of details they provide. Well, they decompose the steps, they explain the mechanics, they explain the feeling, and lately they explain musicality.
I've personally noticed that since we've been taking classes from Bryant and Faye, I feel like I have better posture and I move with more...
Core is more consciousness of our core.
I like the idea that they teach a solid posture and a solid foundation for all the beginners instead of teaching the steps right away.
So if your question is, what is your style of dancing in Argentine tango? We don't have styles. We have expressions. So I could tell you what my background is to tell you a little bit defining what style I am. My background is I grew up around my family from the folk background in Argentina. I grew up in the country a lot, around cowboys, which we call gauchos. So then I went into tango in an era where tango was fairly close embrace, and you weren't allowed to pick up your feet off the floor. And you had to be elegant to be allowed to walk into the dance floor. One of the things that attracted me the most was the first time I attended a milonga. I walked in and I was sitting down, you know, checking out everything that was going on. And I'm sitting in the background, you know, in the darkest place. And I see about 100-year-old man get up and ask a lady to dance. He does the cabeceo. And he grabs his jacket and with two fingers, he's able to button the jacket, only with using two fingers. He went like this, and 1 second he had his jacket buttoned, and then he went to dance with her. I think that's what marked me the most about my first experience in Argentine tango. From the perspective of Tango Soul, I would let people know that my background, it's what has shaped Tango Soul, and also my wife's background, because she's from Quebec. We come from two different parts of the world, but very cultural, very proud. So that is something not to be ashamed of being proud in Argentine tango, because that's what makes you a better dancer. coming from Argentina, yeah, culturally we're very different. We're very touchy. We hug a lot. You know, we drink mate. It's like you spend a lot of time more, you know, socializing that people do here. And it's really hard to teach that within 1 hour of a class a week.
I think where I learned the most about tango is by talking with masters, talking with Bryant, being around people. And then after that, when they do the dance, you have a totally different perspective.
Well, you mentioned you want to be a great belongero. How do you define a great belongero?
For me, they had self-respect.
It was wonderful. It was wonderful in terms of interaction. People had questions. There were answers. Also, I liked the idea of getting the history of the teachers that we're dealing with, the mannerisms of what they've learned in their time, what they want to bring to us, and that they're open to questions and getting out what we would like to have as well. So it was very 50-50 in terms of that, which I liked very much. I never had a chat before. So this was very unique and very, very, very good. I enjoyed it a lot.
My cabecil is an Argentine cabecil, right?
I found it difficult teaching in North America culturally. I found it very hard at the beginning, but it's taught me a lot also about people worldwide that I learned mostly that just about everybody wants the same thing, to enjoy a good moment. The most enjoyable part of teaching, when a student shows up to your class and he can't wait to be there early and he can't wait to leave late.